हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू ऑल सब्जेक्ट इंडस्ट्रियल इंजीनियरिंग चैप्टर इन्वेंटरी कंट्रोल टॉपिक ईओक्यू मॉडल पार्ट वन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ टॉपिक विच नेम एज इकोनॉमिक ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी मॉडल पार्ट वन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट। Economic order quantity EOQ model is also known as a Harris-Wilson model, or we can say that infinite rate of replenishment. First of all, we are going to discuss some terminology which are associated with the EOQ model. First terminology is capital D. Capital D is annual or yearly demand of inventory items, or we can say that annually or yearly consumptions of inventory item. It is represented in units per year. What is a capital Q? Capital Q is quantity to be ordered at each order point. It is represented in the unit per order. We can say that capital Q is represent how much amount of inventory item to be ordered at each order point. It is represented in units per order. What is a capital N, students? Capital N is a number of order placed in a year. It is represent in order per year. How many time our organization place an order in a year? And capital N is represent as a capital D with respect to Q. And what is a unit of capital D? Is a units per year. And what is a unit of capital Q? It is a unit per order. So here the unit of N is order per year. Clear, students? N is represented as capital D by Q, and the unit of N is order per year. Let's take an example. The annually consumption of inventory item capital D is given as a 36,000 unit per year, and capital Q is given as a 9,000 units per order. What is a capital N? So we can write as a capital N is nothing but capital D by Q, and capital D is 36,000 given in question, and Q is 9,000. So here the four order per year is your answer. So here we can conclude that in a year our organization plays a four order. Clear to all, student? Okay. What is a capital T? Capital T is represented as a length of one inventory cycle or a time gap between a two successive order. Okay, students? T is nothing but length of one inventory cycle or a time gap between a two successive order. It is represented as a year per order. Or T is also represented as a 1 by N. In the previous slide, we will discuss about capital N. N is nothing but capital D by Q. Here the T is 1 by N. And N is represent a number of order to be placed in a year. So N, the units of N is a order per year. So what is a unit of T? It is a year per order. Clear to all, students? What is a capital T? It is a length of one inventory cycle or a time gap between a two successive order. It represent in the year per order. So this N is goes to a right side. So T into N is equal to 1. It is an important relation which is used in the derivation of the EOQ model. Let's take an example. If the N is given as 4 order per year, so what is a capital T? So capital T is nothing but 1 divided by N. So 1 by 4 year per order. So if this is converted into the month, so 1 by 4 into 12, 3 month per order is nothing but a length of one inventory cycle or a time gap between a two successive order. Clear to all, students? What is a capital T and what is a capital N? Let's move. Capital C. Capital C is nothing but a purchasing cost of one unit of inventory item. Purchasing cost of one unit of inventory item, or we can say that a purchasing cost of particular of one unit of inventory item. It is represented in the rupees per unit. Okay, student. C naught is a cost of placing a one order. Okay, it is a ordering cost of one order. It is represented in the rupees per order. What is a CH? CH is nothing but cost of holding a one unit in inventory for a one complete year. Okay, cost of holding a one unit in inventory for a one complete year. Or we can say is that a holding cost of one unit in an inventory for one complete year. It is represented as a rupees per unit per year. Clear to all what is a C naught and what is a CH? Okay, students. A small d is nothing but demand rate or a consumption rate. Demand rate or a consumption rate. But the main difference in the capital D and small d is that the capital D is a yearly consumption. It is represented in the units per year, but small d is represented in the units per day or a units per month. Okay, students, a small d is a demand rate or a consumption rate. Okay. Look at the figure very carefully. On x-axis, I represent as a time. On y-axis, I represent as an inventory level in units. At this point, at time is equals to 0, our organization place an order and fill the inventory up to a maximum inventory level at Q. So at time is equals to 0, our organization fill a inventory with infinite rate. So we can say that EOQ model is also known as infinite rate of replenishment. Okay, students, at time is equals to 0, our organization fill a inventory up to the maximum inventory level with infinite rate. So after that point, after this point, our organization consume inventory with consumption rate small d, consume a maximum inventory with a consumption rate small d, and reaches to the reorder level. Reorder level is that level at which our organization plays a new order. So after this reorder level, our inventory is consumed with small d and reaches to this point. At this point, the Q tends to 0. At this point, Q tends to 0. Further, our organization is fill the inventory with infinite rate and fill up to the maximum inventory level capital Q. Okay, student. And this time gap is represented as a lead time. The lead time is represent as a time gap between the reorder level, or we can say is that a time gap between the placing an order and order is reaches in our inventory. Here the capital T is represented as a time gap between two successive orders, successive order 1 and second order. Or we can say is that the length of one cycle time. Here this is represented as a one cycle. Clear to all? Here, from the graph, we can say that the inventory level Q, capital Q, is consumed in the time capital T with consumption rate small d. So we can written as capital Q is nothing but capital T into small d. This inventory level is consumed in capital T time with consumption rate small d. Similarly, we can written as reorder level is consumed with the time lead time and with consumption rate small d. Reorder level is nothing but a lead time into a demand rate or a consumption rate. Clear to all? Here, in the previous slide, we had discussed the capital Q is represented as a capital T into D. This amount of inventory level is consumed in the capital T time with consumption rate small d. And capital T is nothing but length of one इन्वेंट्री साइकिल और अ टाइम गैप बिटवीन अ टू सक्सेसिव ऑर्डर. सिमिलरली रीऑर्डर लेवल इज रिप्रेजेंट एज अ लीड टाइम इनटू अ डी. डी इज अ डिमांड रेट और अ कंजम्पशन रेट. सो सिमिलरली द स्मॉल डी इज रिप्रेजेंट एज अ कैपिटल क्यू बाय टी. दिस इज कम फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन कैपिटल क्यू बाय टी एंड स्मॉल डी इज रिप्रेजेंट एज अ रीऑर्डर लेवल बाय लीड टाइम. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर्मूला, रिमेंबर दिस. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो डिस्कस अ टोटल एनुअल कॉस्ट. वॉट इज अ टोटल एनुअल कॉस्ट? टोटल एनुअल कॉस्ट इज नथिंग बट अ परचेसिंग कॉस्ट प्लस ऑर्डरिंग कॉस्ट प्लस होल्डिंग कॉस्ट. ओके स्टूडेंट, परचेसिंग कॉस्ट प्लस ऑर्डरिंग कॉस्ट प्लस होल्डिंग कॉस्ट. वॉट इज अ परचेसिंग कॉस्ट? परचेसिंग कॉस्ट is nothing but the annually consumption of inventory item into a purchasing cost of one unit. Purchasing cost of one unit. So purchasing cost is represent capital D into C. Okay, friend. What is the ordering cost? Ordering cost is nothing but a number of order placed in year into ordering cost to place a one order. It is a ordering cost of one order and it is represent as a number of order placed in a year. So n into c naught is represent as a total ordering cost, and we know that the capital N is represent as capital D by Q. So we written as ordering cost is D by Q into c naught. Clear to all students? So move in the next. What is a holding cost? Please see carefully. What is a holding cost? Holding cost is nothing but average inventory for a period into holding cost per unit per time. This holding cost per unit per time is represented as a CH, and CH is a holding cost for a per unit and per time. Okay, student? So in the EOQ model, in EOQ model or infinite rate of replenishment, infinite rate of replenishment, our average inventory is nothing but 0 plus Q by 2 or Q by 2. Okay, students, in a graph, here it is represented as a T, or Y-axis is represented as a inventory at point Q level. This is represented as a our graph. Okay, students. So what is the average inventory? Here is zero inventory and here is a Q. 0 plus Q by 2, and Q by 2 is a average inventory. Q by 2 is a average inventory and holding cost for a T period. Okay, students, holding cost for a T period is written as a average inventory Q by 2 for a time period capital T into holding cost per unit per time. So we can written as a Q by 2 into CH into T. But here our requirement is a annual holding cost. Annual holding cost. So here in the above equation, we can multiply in the capital N, and N is nothing but a number of order per year. So T into N, in the previous slide we have discussed that T into N is nothing but 1. So our holding cost is Q by 2 into CH. Okay, student. So what is the total annual cost? Total annual cost is a purchasing cost plus ordering cost plus holding cost. What is the purchasing cost? D into capital C. And what is the ordering cost? D by Q into C0. And what is the holding cost? Q by 2 into CH. Clear to all students? Total variable cost or total inventory cost. In the previous slide, we will discuss a total annual cost. Total annual cost is nothing but purchasing cost plus ordering cost plus holding cost. But the purchasing cost is a constant cost. It is a not variable. It is a constant. But the ordering cost and holding cost is a variable cost. So this cost, the holding cost, the ordering cost plus holding cost is nothing but a total inventory cost. So a total inventory cost is nothing but a ordering cost D by Q into C0 plus holding cost Q by 2 into CH. So total annual cost is represented as a purchasing cost plus total inventory cost. Clear to all students, what is the total annual cost and what is the total inventory cost? Okay, friend. Thank you so much for watching. To be continued in next topic. In next topic, we will discuss about derivation of economic order quantity or derivation of optimal total inventory cost.